I'm Andrew Edwards, and you're watching Gear Live. For the first time in 7 years, Apple just redesigned the MacBook Air. The MacBook Air is Apple's most popular computer that they sell by far, and we finally got a new form factor and a more powerful package. If you just picked up a MacBook Air, you may be looking for some of the best apps for macOS to run on it, and in this video, I give you a look at 5 of my favorites. What is going on, Tech Squad? Andrew Edwards here, editor-in-chief for GearLife.com. If this is your first time here, this channel is all about tech, gadgets, and gaming. So if you're into that kind of stuff, feel free to hit the subscribe button down below, along with the bell notification icon, so you don't miss any future videos. As I mentioned today, I'm telling you about 5 of my favorite apps for the MacBook Air. If you picked up a new MacBook Air and you're looking for some apps to run on it, to be more productive, to have a little more fun, this video is for you. Now, of course, these apps don't just run on the new MacBook Air. They'll also run on other Macs, the iMac, the Mac Mini, the Mac Pro, and of course, the MacBook Pro as well. And by the way, big shout out to Unboxed for sponsoring this episode. If you're unaware, Unboxed aims to be the home of the top tech experts and creators on YouTube, where you can see their latest videos, the products they're talking about, and even lists of the top trends in the tech community. More on them later in the video. So let's kick this off with one of the first apps that I install on every single Mac that I buy and set up. That is Clean My Mac X. If you've ever found yourself hunting around for useless files to delete on your Mac because of the dreaded low disk space alert, then you definitely need to download Clean My Mac X. Clean My Mac X is your new personal Mac genius, and it replaces dozens of optimization tools on your computer. It's an OS cleaner, performance monitor, malware remover, and more. Clean My Mac X sifts through your computer's junk in all areas of macOS. It cleans all of your unneeded files like outdated caches, downloads, logs, and useless localizations. Not to mention it has the ability to reduce the clutter that eats up a ton of hard drive space in applications like iTunes, mail, photos, and also countless other gigabytes of large hidden files. The best part is the app is fast, smart, and here to do the heavy lifting for you. With the press of one button, you gain precious hard drive space instantly. There's also no need to worry about deleting important files by accident. The safety database that's built into Clean My Mac X tells junk apart from important files. The app will never delete anything without asking, and the smart assistant can guide you through regular disk cleanups so you don't have to keep waiting until you're out of disk space again in order to make more room. Another fantastic feature is the ability to increase speed and performance on your Mac with a full deck of speed up tools. This includes the ability to free up RAM on the fly, run maintenance scripts, control for login items, launch agents, and much more to help lessen the load on your system and boost your speed as well as your productivity. All right, that was Clean My Mac X. Next app on my list helps you with a cluttered menu bar. On a smaller display, that menu bar, all the icons up there, all the apps that run up there will start to take over your system. Bartender is an app that will help you keep it organized. Bartender 3 lets you organize your menu bar icons by hiding them, rearranging them, showing hidden items with a click or keyboard shortcut, and having icons show when they update. This one app allows you to quickly create a cleaner, less cluttered interface on your macOS desktop. If you're like me, you have a ton of different apps on your Mac, and it might be a bit difficult to keep track of everything, especially if these apps have menu bar icons. Things can get out of control up there and very cluttered. Thankfully, Bartender is an app that aims to help clean up that clutter and bring some sanity back to the menu bar for you. Bartender 3 lets you organize your menu bar icons by hiding them or rearranging them, giving you control over what's displayed in the menu bar or what's completely hidden. This option is perfect for those who don't like a cluttered menu bar, but still want to be able to access some menu bar icons at any moment. Once you install Bartender 3, open the preferences menu and start going through the available apps that appear in your menu bar. You can choose between various options like show, hide, always show, or always hide. If you choose to hide an app, the app icon will go into the Bartender 3 icon, and whenever you need to access the hidden applications, simply click the Bartender 3 menu bar icon. If you really want to go for a clean look, you can even hide the Bartender 3 menu bar icon itself, but don't worry, and you can bring it up anytime using your custom keyboard command. All right, now let's talk about another app that I love. This one is called DropShare. We live in a world where we're constantly sharing things, whether you're sharing on social media, you're sharing with colleagues, you're sharing with your spouse or your family. DropShare makes sharing super simple and super easy using either the DropShare cloud or any cloud storage service of your choice. Take a look. DropShare is a simple drag and drop uploader to get files of any type to the platform of your choice. There are plenty of other ways to upload files too, like system-wide custom keyboard shortcuts or even the macOS share extension. DropShare is more than just an uploader. It allows you to annotate your screenshots before you share them with the world. You can use DropShare's built-in annotator, or you can set it to use your own annotation app of choice. DropShare also allows you to capture your screen in either video or GIF format. This app is highly configurable as well. You've got options like how to name screenshots you've taken and what URL shortening service to use by default. When it comes to support for cloud storage apps, DropShare supports all the main solutions, and it even gives you the option of using your own server through SSH. This is awesome for anyone who'd rather keep things in-house, but has been lacking an easy and intuitive way to share files. DropShare is the simplest way to upload files of any type and share them in no time. With its highly customizable options and support for dark mode, you can make sure it works just how you want it to. Now, before we move on to the last two apps in this list, I want to tell you more about the sponsor of this video, Unboxed. Unboxed gives you a place on the web to connect with your favorite tech creators. As an example, here you can see my profile, which tells you a little bit about my channel, shows you the products I've been talking about recently, displays the newest videos I've published, and even pulls in my social media content as well. If you love watching tech content, then Unboxed will not only recommend who else you should be watching, but it'll also link you to the hottest products being talked about. Head over to unboxed.tv to check it out. And if you're a tech creator, get your account set up and claim your space on Unboxed by heading over to unboxed.tv/signup. One thing I like to keep tabs on whenever I'm using my Mac, regardless of which Mac it is how it's performing under the hood. I wanna know how much RAM is being used, how much is free, how much the processor is being pushed, what's the speed of the data that I'm downloading and uploading, and so much more. And to do that, I use an app called iStat Menus. Here's why I love it. This app adds an icon to the top bar of your Mac that shows you how your battery life drains over time and can help you figure out what apps you're using the most when the drain occurs. And now, last but not least, here in my five apps that you should install on your brand new Apple MacBook Air is Get Backup Pro. Most people don't think about backups. Most people don't care about backups, but Get Backup Pro is an essential tool that will save you in the event of data loss or will help you when you get a new machine to get right back up and running. Get Backup Pro gives you the full flexibility to decide what you're backing up and where. You can choose between a full backup, specific folders, and even doing incremental backups as well. Thanks to the bootable backups via the cloning feature, you'll be able to get your Mac back up and running in no time in the unlikely event that the installation goes wrong. To create a backup, go to the Backups tab and click the plus button. Select the source you want to back up and the destination it's going to, such as an external hard drive. Creating a bootable clone is the same process, but just under the Clone tab instead. All right, now for a bonus app. We just talked about Get Backup Pro, which helps you to back up your computer locally, but Backblaze is the service that helped me get back up and running a couple of weeks ago when I suffered severe data loss on a 2 terabyte drive that was full of video projects that I was working on. Video projects that were work that I was working on. Backblaze for $5 per month will back up unlimited amount of storage. So everything on your computer and anything on any drive that's plugged into your computer, Backblaze will back all of that up. So if you lose any of that at any time, you can either download it or ask them to send it to you on a drive. And if they send it to you on a drive and you pull the data off and send the drive back to them, they refund you for the cost of the drive, making that service free. It's $5 a month if you wanna pay monthly. I actually pay $95 for 2 years, which brings the cost to about $3.40 a month for that peace of mind. So Backblaze is my 6th bonus app if you wanna stay secure. And I will leave a link down in the description below so you can try Backblaze absolutely free for a couple of weeks. Now, all the apps I mentioned today, with the exception of Backblaze, can be found on SetApp. If you're unaware, SetApp is a monthly subscription service, kind of like Netflix, where for $10 a month, $9.99 a month, you get unlimited access to over 100 of the best Mac apps that you can find here on planet Earth. They are not a sponsor either, but I do work with said app on videos for their channel. And that's how I've gotten to learn about a bunch of these different apps. These are five of my favorites. If you haven't tried SetApp before, you can actually head over there, setapp.com, to get a free 7-day trial and download as many of the 100 apps as you want to give it a shot. There you have it, guys. That was my look at five apps that I love that you should install on your brand new MacBook Air. Or if you don't have a new MacBook Air, you can install these on any Mac, obviously, that's running a current version of macOS. Thanks so much for watching, as always, guys. Now I wanna hear from you. Drop a comment down below and let me know, what are your favorite Mac apps? I need to check out more apps. I'm a big fan of Mac apps. What are the ones that you love? Comment down below. I will meet you there for further discussion. Don't forget, we have a bunch of giveaways coming up in November and December. We have at least, let's see, we have the TCL 55-inch 6-series TV. We have the Anki Overdrive. We have the Apple Watch Series 4 Nike Edition. And that's not even everything. I know we have at least two more. So within the next 8 weeks, we'll have at least five giveaways starting. So keep it locked here on the channel. And by the way, if you're a channel member, link in the description below. If you're a channel member, you get bonus entries into each and every giveaway that we do as my way of saying thank you. So there you have it, guys. Let me know what you think. Comment down below. Like I said, I'll meet you down there and we'll talk about all this stuff. Thank you so much for watching, as always. I appreciate your support. I'm Andrew Edwards and I will catch you in the next video.